came in, the air went out. And every shadow filled up with doubt. I don't know who you think you are, but before the night is through, I wanna do bad things with you. I'm the cat who sit up in his room, heartsick and eyes filled up with gloom.
We're here with David Tishman and Mariah Hooner, who co-write the True Blood comic book series, and we're really excited because there's a big kickoff here in New York City at the HBO store, featuring all kinds of artwork and collectibles from the series, as well as your comic book. How many volumes have you guys written so far?
Well, we have written 6 issues of the first volume, so that's our first one. But there will be more coming up, which is very exciting for us. But yeah, that's the first one, at least. It is
a 6-part story.
Yep.
I think issue 4 comes out this week. So we will have 2 more issues after that, and then it'll be collected and in comic book stores and in bookstores as one single volume of the 6 issues, and then we'll move on to the next story.
Now, for people who are fans of the TV series, maybe you could explain what telling the story in comic book form does, what's advantageous of seeing the story in a comic book.
There's a lot of different things. The first is really the story. We're able to sort of tell some stories that the show hasn't been able to get into because it's such a frenetic, fast pace. So we were able to really get into some core emotional moments for the characters, and they're things that nobody's seen before, and they are canon, like, they are real stories that take, like, the characters' lives. The other nice thing about comics as a format is that we're able to do things with the art that a show can't suddenly do watercolor, but we can do that from different characters' perspectives. So each character has their own story in each issue, and we were able to really give them their own personality. And the other thing was really able to do a big creepy monster that would look probably weird if you tried to do it with special effects. It's got tentacles and an unhinged jaw and stuff. So, yeah, that was a lot of fun.
You know, the story is that all of the main characters are trapped in Murlocs over the course of one night. And there is a monster who, in order to get free, they each have to explain their most shameful moment. So each of the stories that we're telling in flashback is a core emotional moment for each of the characters. Sookie, Bill, all of your favorite characters. And these are original stories that have never been dramatized on the show and yet are part of the show. So we actually, you know, this season a lot of time was spent with Lafayette and his mother, and we were able to go back and work with Alan Ball and with the showrunners for this season and get in there and talk about, you know, Lafayette dealing with his homosexuality when he was a kid and how his mother felt about that, and how that sort of came around the same time as her going a little crazy. And it ended up being a very, very dramatic time for him. And it's something that was great that we really enjoyed doing with Lafayette because we love the character. And he really is such a great mix of those crazy one-liners and really deeply dramatic moments.
Now, in terms of and how you guys write, maybe you could tell us a bit of some of your influences, both in the comic book realm as well as in literature and film.
You know, I think it's just important to read. If you're a writer, I think it's just important to read. You can't just sit in a room all alone all day, or even when you're working with someone and you're passing it back and forth. You need to read other writers, you need to read other things, you need to read newspapers, you need to watch the news. You need to read Dracula if you're doing vampires. You need to see, you know, you need to watch Angel and Buffy, which we've probably done way too much. But I think the most important thing is you really do. If you're going to be a writer, you need to read, no matter what it is.
And for me, I'm a big nerd. So, you know, if there's a nerdy thing, I mean, Buffy Angel is definitely an influence on things. The True Blood show itself is obviously an influence on the book. If we weren't fans of that, we would not be able to write it because it's very distinct characters. It's a very distinct world. You can't just sort of go, oh, guess what'll happen. You have to really know what's going on. And if I can possibly work it in anything, I'll say Muppets, because Muppets are always an influence on me, no matter what I'm doing. So there's that.
Well, thanks so much for talking with us, you guys. And congrats on getting through this first six, and hope to see much more from you guys.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot. Thank you.
I don't know what you've done to me, but I know the smouch is true. I want to do bad things with you. I want to do real.